Hi, I'm Linda Press-Wolf. Welcome to another episode of Dining Out in Lewisboro, an ongoing television series highlighting fine restaurants in and around Lewisboro. Today, I'll be talking with Remy Hote, owner and executive chef, and his son, Coz Hote, manager of La Vista restaurant situated here in South Salem, New York. So let me ask you, when did you open and what made you decide to locate in South Salem?
Yes, Linda, we opened in November 2015. We decided to come here. It was much more closer to home. We live in Stanford, me and my family, and it's a beautiful area. We like the location. We expressed our knowledge through gardening, and we just love the town.
Well, we're very fortunate to have you here in town.
Thank you.
So tell our viewers, what's unique or special about La Vista Restaurant?
Well, when we first came here, my father wanted to do a tour of Italy. Walking into La Vista, you would have the fresh herbs alongside. Walking in, you could see the grappas and just everything would make you feel so cozy. So the lighting inside, the table set up, feel like home.
You know, the decor here is very cozy and welcoming. So what influenced the design and some of the interior elements?
Well, when we came in, the lighting, the green lighting, it makes people feel much more homey. So when people come in, they see the chairs, they're red and the green, and the food out, the gardens, everybody feels like they can express themselves more at a fine dining restaurant. A good ambience.
Mm-hmm. Well, I would agree. The ambiance here is really lovely.
Thank you.
How would you describe the cuisine and what are some of the restaurant's most popular, most requested dishes?
A good dish is a Pollo Principesse, which is a breaded chicken and Parmesan cheese, lemon white wine sauce with fresh herbs, olive oil, and garlic. Also, a veal saltimbocca, which is pounded veal, very thin, when in flour. Also with spinach, prosciutto, fresh mozzarella, and a bottle of wine sauce. These two dishes are excellent. Everybody loves them.
I'm getting hungry just thinking about them. So tell us a little bit more about the menu, your appetizer, entree selections, and desserts.
Well, we have the long-stem artichoke hearts, which they're breaded, and aioli sauce and cannellini bean salad. We also move to tuna wasabi, which is a very rare ahi tuna with a seaweed salad and a pickled ginger. Also moving forward, we have the La Vista salad, which is our signature dish with poached pear over Boston bib with gorgonzola cheese. It's excellent. Moving forward, we have the linguine white clam sauce, which everyone loves. It's a signature old classic dish. Fresh linguine with clams and a light white wine sauce. I would say the New York strip steak, moving forward in the end, is a 21-day dry-aged steak. It's smoked in the house and delivered to you, medium rare. It's excellent with fresh vegetables.
And you have chicken dishes, veal
yes.
dishes, seafood dishes.
Mm-hmm. All the above. Also the salmon abrisiana, which is lightly pan-seared, lemon butter sauce, and piccata.
Oh, that sounds delicious. And excellent. Desserts? Tell us about your desserts.
Desserts. Walking into the restaurant, there's a whole display of desserts. We go from creme brulee to, they're all homemade. Creme brulee, New York style cheesecake, to a chocolate tart. Wonderful.
Zabaglione that we do on table side, which is like I come out of the kitchen, I do the Zabaglione, which is many Italians didn't do it right now in a restaurant, so mm-hmm. I love to do it.
It's a lovely dish. Served with some fresh berries or
exactly,
on its own?
Exactly, served with the fresh raspberries, blueberries, and the strawberries, which is excellent. People, they love it. Mm-hmm. It's like a show in front of the customers. Mm-hmm.
Now, the desserts, you say they're all homemade.
Yes.
Who's the pastry chef in the family?
Well, we work together.
Yes.
I have my father working in. We come in the morning, and he just looking at him and doing the eggs and vanilla extract, and you just learn everything. But we like to show how we make it, especially in front of the customers. It's not only behind the scenes.
And would you describe the menu more as Mediterranean or Italian or a combination?
I would say Northern and Southern Italian, a mix of both.
Now let's shift to your wine list. You have an extensive selection.
Yes, we do.
Tell us a little bit more about that.
We have from Bertani, Maroni, Valpolicella per Passo, going down to Tuscany, on the Chianti Reserva is excellent, the classical. Pimento, which you have the Barolos, 2008s, 2011s. Moving forward, we go to California Cabernet, which is everybody loves Kokomo, Alexander Valley. Mm-hmm. Moving forward to Duckhorn, and we have Sesakaya. But these are beautiful wines.
Yes, reds, the Amarones. Barolos.
Actually, we have a huge selection of wines. Mm-hmm. We're talking region of Italy, especially Californians, Chile, Spain, France. Mm-hmm. We go to every little country. Washington State wines, which is excellent. They do with, very good wines. I love wines, so that's why I go with this section of region of every country.
Can someone order something that's not on the menu?
Yes, it happens all the time. Mm-hmm. And we allow that, we accept it. We know that people have different tastes and they want different things, and we usually move forward with that. As a business, as a restaurateur, mm-hmm. you have all different types of food and dealing with all different types of people.
Especially I'm in the kitchen, so I will never say no.
And so no
he has
need,
to say yes.
No need to call in advance.
No,
they can
no,
let you know
no,
when
no,
they're
no.
here.
Even,
in the
restaurant. Even if they want me to cook right in front of them, I'll come because I have a beautiful staff in the kitchen. Mm-hmm. So I grew up loving what I do with my family.
And talking about the kitchen, is there anything special we should know about the kitchen and what's happening behind the scenes?
Behind the scenes, I can tell you about the kitchen. Because I'm there like 24/7, it's like my baby. When I built this restaurant, I built the kitchen stainless steel. English stainless steel, so I keep it neat and clean. So when my employees work there, they feel like they are, some different world. Look in the kitchen, stainless steel, clean. Everything is set up the way I want to do it. That was a question when you asked my son about the about the customers, if they want something different.
Right.
Always I tell my staff, you never refuse the customers. I'm in the kitchen. I have the staff in the kitchen. I make anything they wanted. My hands are there. They want a veal parmesan. They want something. They see it in TV. All they got to say the name. I make it.
That's a good philosophy to have in the restaurant business, service business.
Yeah. And I have 8 staff working in the behind me. They are good people. They love what they do. Mm-hmm. I'm there with them in the morning to the evening. The good staff, to tell you the truth.
And it is a 24/7 business,
it
isn't
it? It is 24/7.
Yes. Even if
I didn't want my kids to be in this business, but they're born in the Bronx, so that's
they had no choice. Do you cater off premises?
Yes, we do. We cater to about 140 people top. Mm-hmm. We have a catering menu available, and we also do private parties.
Oh, you can have a private party here.
Yes.
Oh, good.
We do.
Good.
We have prefix menus for private parties. Mm-hmm. We would like to work all around.
Now, I'm sure our viewers would like to know kind of a little bit of background about you both. Where did you learn your chef skills, mastering the art of Italian cooking and restaurant management?
Yes. Well, my father came in New York City in the early 80s, and he learned, and back then the restaurant was very tough. It was very hard to get a job. So he worked, and being that, he learned quickly. So then,
also was in my family where I came from. We did it in the restaurant industry.
Mm-hmm. He worked in he got his own place in Finos, which is New York City, 36 and 5th. He owned that for about 15 years. We decided to come here, move a little closer. But back home, we built crops, we garden peppers, tomatoes, melons, many fresh herbs. So coming here now as a family, we're working together. It's something new. It's something new to us, and it's something, it's grateful. I feel grateful.
And you learned from your dad, right?
I learned from my dad.
And Remy, you learned hands-on, right? From the ground up, working in the restaurant kitchen and then having your own business.
35 years I'm doing this industry as a cooking. Mm-hmm. Then I owned the restaurant for 14 years, like my son says, in Fino. It was the greatest area between 5th and Madison, 36th Street. I came here, I see opportunity in Lewisboro to create things, people to see it, what means food That's me and my wife. Actually, we built a garden last year with these people. They love it. I did the plum tomatoes, beef tomatoes, cherry tomatoes, cucumbers, three different peppers, Italian peppers, banana peppers, cherry peppers, flowers.
And the fresh herbs, I'm sure,
fresh herbs,
too, right?
Basil, parsley, thyme. It's amazing. Something that's organic. So people, when they walk in a restaurant, they smell it. They sit in a patio, they smell basil. Mm-hmm. They smell sage, they smell mint. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And you grab it, you just go outside, you grab it and you cook it.
It's a beautiful experience.
For me, it's like being in Sicily, being in Italy, when you see this place, because with all the vegetables and gardens and patio, that was the reason, and I love this town a lot. It's opportunity. My kids born here, my kids love what they doing with me. My daughter, she's here, and that was the reason.
It's truly a family business.
Truly a family business.
I can feel the love and the heart behind this business. Yeah. Now, in the restaurant, in the dining room, I notice gyrodon, the art of tableside food preparation, is not available in many restaurants today, but fortunately here, it's a specialty at La Vista. So what dishes are usually prepared tableside?
Today what I'm gonna do, Rita, I'm gonna make some very old Italian tradition dish called penne filetto pomodoro. Mm. So it's gonna be a fresh plum tomatoes, sweet onions, garlic, parsley, prosciutto, and vodka with the fresh plum tomatoes.
Oh, that sounds delicious.
It's a very nice light dish, and it's especially when you drink with a nice Chianti wine, it's excellent.
And what else would you prepare tableside?
We also do branzinos, which is a whole fish. It's a Mediterranean sea bass. Mm-hmm. Filet for you whole with fresh garlic, olive oil, a little rosemary, and brought to you in a flaming fire. Might move back a little bit there. It's brought to you sizzling, hot plate. Also, we do Dover sole, which is a more delicate fish, pompano, snapper. We range from the menu all the way down to the table.
Yeah. And other pasta dishes besides filetto di pomodoro?
All the homemade pasta that I make, I do pappardelle with three, four mushrooms. It's different mushrooms cooking right in front of the customers. And fettuccine, linguine puttanesca, which is...
Also table size.
Linguine carbonara, which is a very, very... those old Italian tradition dishes. And they're all homemade, the pasta, and it gives the flavor right in front of the customers, and they see it, what I put there. Mm-hmm. It's just, they love it. It's just...
That's the look we go for, is being presentable as a presentation, as a family. The tableside work expresses what we do and what we are.
When you walk in, there's a very inviting bar. It's a full-service bar, I imagine.
That's correct.
Tell us a little bit more about.
Yes, walking into the bar, it's very open. You have the chairs nice set up on the marble granite. Also overlooking to the left, you have many shelves of, it's like a picture of Italy. Walking in, you have grappas, you have single molds, you have the glasses that are nice. Walking in, you have the shelves that are full with wine. To the left, you have many different types of wines, the liquor. To the right, you can sit down and enjoy a nice table with your loved one, or maybe a couple kids. We give full service at the bar.
And you have premium products on the bar. You have a full selection of wines, spirits.
Yes. Yes.
And
yes.
Can you order anything off the menu and have it at the bar? Or
yes.
Do you have a different selection?
A lot of people order appetizers. Now we have a new bar menu. We have a new cocktail list that we're putting up. When people sit at the bar, we like to also like to sit in the dining room. We give them a little bruschetta, meaning a cheese plate full of olives, soppressata, cheeses, and a bread with a tomato salad.
Just enough to whet your appetite,
just
get
enough.
You ready for a great meal.
Just to start a little bit to get the appetite for the drinks.
Make them feel at home.
Yes, that's lovely. Well, how about joining me for tableside preparation? What are you going to prepare for us this afternoon?
My father is going to start by preparing the filetto pomodoro, correct?
Yes, the penne with filetto pomodoro, which is we'll see it right now, is everything fresh.
And then we'll move to the signature branzini.
Ah, lovely. All right, join me for the tableside preparation.
Thank you.
All right, what I'm about to do here, I'm making a penne filetto pomodoro, which is a very Italian tradition pasta, which is I'm using the virgin olive oil. What I do, I use the garlic, gives a fresh garlic, gives a flavor. Which is a very important. It's a butter which is I make it myself here. It's not fattened because people today they scared from the butter, but this is no, it's no fattening butters, which is excellent. This is a fresh rosemary. I got some basil here, which is I do in my garden. What we have here, we let the oil to ingredient get in very hot so the garlic can be a little roasted with fresh rosemary and basil. We use the onions, sweet onions. We stir a little bit so it just gives the flavor. You spread the flavor in the pan with the garlic, herbs, and onions. Then I use the fresh plum tomatoes, it's excellent. That's what gives the always, I love basil, so I have to use it. So it's something that gives. Then we have the prosciutto. This is the beauty. As you can see, you smell the prosciutto, you smell the onions, you smell the garlic, you smell the plum tomatoes. And that's what the ingredient comes the pasta in. And finally, when it starts like cooking a little bit, actually we call sauté. This is sauté. We use a little vodka. And then I got the fresh plum tomatoes, like a marinara, but I made it with the fresh plum tomatoes. Awesome, Vima. And this is a vegetables sauce. And I put a little bit more virgin olive oil. It just gives a little more flavor. Okay, it takes like a minute and a half. The sauce is inside. Now it's with garlic, onions, prosciutto, herbs. You let it boil a little bit, and then we use the pasta, which as you can see, it, the sauce of ready, the ingredient is in. Now we have the penne. You have to stir the pasta. You gotta make sure the sauce is all over the penne pasta, so you cannot miss one little penne without having the sauce. We got the grated Parmesan cheese from Sicily, which is very, very good. Now, I think I'm crazy with the basil, but I love basil, so that's what makes the pasta taste excellent. See, now the Parmesan cheese is in. You let it like a minute and a half. It will give the taste inside of the pasta, so when the customers sit down and taste this pasta, you don't need to put Parmesan cheese anymore because everything is here. As you see the color of the pasta, how it changed from the fresh plum tomatoes, from the tomato sauce, with Parmesan cheese, it became like a little of the sauce like in pink side, but it's not creamy. Because of the Parmesan cheese. It's a very good Parmesan cheese, makes the pasta very tasty. So ready to go. Now what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna take this here. That was the reason the garidones I make it. So now it's all ready to dish out in the dishes. See, this is the beauty. It's so light. It's not too much sauce, like streaming the pasta and the sauce, which is I don't like that, because the pasta already is sucked the sauce inside, so the customers they love it. Now we have the basil here. And it's ready to go. This is the pasta filetta pomodoro from La Vista restaurant. Thank you very much.
Today we'll be filleting the beautiful branzino. It's a Mediterranean sea bass, prepared for you tableside. Put a little oil. Not too much. Okay. A little garlic, always use garlic. It's excellent. A little rosemary. Little basil. I'm not like my father. I don't use too much. Get the hot plate sizzling. So we stuffed the branzino with garlic, fresh parsley, all these beautiful herbs. Get it nice and going. All right. Now branzino. It's never farm raised. Grew up in the Mediterranean Ocean. Now I slice it through the middle, and it comes out very nice. Beautiful touch. Now the bones are all the way in the center. Yes. We also do Dover sole, which is a more delicate fish. Not that as many bones as the branzino. Now it's filleted for you. I'm just sizzling. Brush. Now we use sambuca. Give it a little taste. Nice. This is a little fresh herbs. We use many different types of liqueurs, Pernod, touch of vodka, some people like a little Chardonnay. And we just swirl it around a little bit, get the lemon inside. Lemon fixes the sauce, gives it a little taste, especially with the fresh herbs. Touch of sambuca, it's excellent. I do this. Now we sizzle the plate, so when it comes to you, it's very hot. Usually we clean the plate around, we let the sauce suck inside the fish because it's excellent. But you have your filet branzino. Buon appetito.
I'd like to thank you both for the exquisite tableside preparation of both the branzino, which just looks and smells absolutely fantastic, and also the penne with the pomodoro sauce. Beautifully done, exquisitely prepared, and I wish viewers could get the experience I have of these wonderful fragrances of the herbs and cheese and fresh flavors that we're experiencing here. And I also wanted to mention that the restaurant has a very impressive selection of breads that are prepared here, home-baked. Everything here has a lot of fresh ingredients and prepared with a lot of love and care. I certainly get that experience here. So, for those who would like more information or to make a reservation here, tell us about the restaurant hours and what days you're open.
Yes, Tuesday through Thursday, we're open at 12 to 10, and Friday from 12 to 11, and Saturday from 3 to 11.
And are reservations required or recommended?
Yes, reservations are recommended.
Mm-hmm. So for those that are interested in maybe off-site catering or private party, who should they contact?
They can contact me, or they can contact my father, whoever's available at the moment.
That's Kaz and Remy Poti. So if you'd like more information, please reach out to the owners and general manager of La Vista Restaurant. Their phone number is 914-533-2671. La Vista is located at 355 Smith Ridge Road, Route 123 in South Salem, or you can visit their website, info@lavistarestaurante.com. So I'd like to thank you both, Remy Poti and Coz Hoti, for inviting us to La Vista, sharing your story, telling us about your very special ingredients, and I encourage our viewers to visit the restaurant often. Until next time, this is Linda Press Wolf for Dining Out in Lewisboro. Thank you for watching LCTV Channel 20, winner of overall excellence in government access public television.
Watching Lewisboro Community Television, Channel 20.